Hello everyone, welcome to the Great Outdoors RV. My name is Mate.
I'm Gary.
And we are here looking at the Cedar Creek Silverback Edition 29IK. Gary, what would you say are the top two or three reasons why somebody should buy a Cedar Creek Silverback?
Well, the construction that we hinted on earlier, it's the R factors, 38. It's the sealed underbelly. It's not like any other built out there today. It's a couple's coach. IK stands for Island Kitchen.
Yep.
It's absolutely awesome.
It is.
You're gonna love this coach.
Yeah, one of the few coaches that are not 40 foot long, but gives you all that room with the opposing slide outs and the construction that backs up the Cedar Creek brand name.
That's the beauty to this 29IK. It's only 33 feet, 11 inches. Dream size, and it's not terribly heavy.
Gary, where should we start?
I think we should start right here at the front.
All right, let's okay? do it.
You have the grab assist oversized handle. As you open the door, which has
friction hinge.
Okay.
So that's kind of nice because that will eliminate it swinging back and forth if you have some big wind and stuff okay. like that. And you do have a little lock handle as well if you need
if
to.
If you need
hook it.
It.
Yeah. Okay.
The other thing that I really like are these new steps that they've come up with. With a little twist of the hand, they're lightweight aluminum steps, okay? And they can adjust. Each runner can come up or come down depending on the level of land.
Okay? Yeah.
What have you
even
got?
An old guy like yourself can manage that?
Yes, even us old guys can do it.
Excellent. You'll notice this has the large door. I like that they didn't put the two small doors that open right. up because those have those dumb little wires
they
that
don't
hang
lock
down.
As well.
Yeah, and you'll notice up here too, there's a light that you can be able to see what you're doing, and this is all plywood decking up here. Aluminum superstructure, and this is all put together with L brackets with siliprene instead of with welds, which gives it a lot of flexibility and strength as you're pulling it down the road. It takes a lot longer to build a coach like this, but in the long run, you're much better off.
It takes twice as long to put this coach together than it would be to tap weld every one of them. This way you get the strength.
Yep.
Okay.
So we do have two 30-pound propane tanks with the auto changeover regulator. So whichever way you point this guy, it will tell you if it's full or empty by the little red or green tabs here, as well as switch from one tank over to the other.
Easy.
As soon as you're ready
easy
for it to do it.
Over.
Or whenever one's empty, I guess.
The other things I'd like to show you, the Furion outside speakers, marine grade. Besides that, if you look up close, we have turned on the LED lights underneath the awning. That gives you a nice, easy glaze of lighting at nighttime, and it doesn't attract the bugs, and yet you're not in the dark. And the last thing I'd like to show you up here is how you can adjust your awning and have all the water, should it rain, pitch down to the left side away from the door and not pile up at the door.
Yep.
That's very important today.
Yeah, I also like that it's just a one push button touch to get it in and out.
Easy.
And I like that these guys are actually still doing the metal wrap over the awning fabric to protect guy from usually.
If you can see it up here, if you can pan away a little bit, you see the metal wrap he's talking about?
Yep, and that'll make it so there's not little pinholes all over the place in 2 years after your coach has been outside.
It protects it. One of the great qualities that this coach has is from down here all the way up, wrapping all the way to the back of the coach and down the other side is what they call flex foil. Okay, a lot of coaches do not have it on the front and the back. They put it on the top and the bottom, that's it. They encompass the whole thing.
That's what gives you that R38 insulation, but in addition to that, they also give you the pink fiberglass fuzzy stuff that you see in your house for insulation.
Doubled insulation, isn't
it's
it?
Actually two layers of that.
Yeah.
And that dead airspace is actually what gives you probably, even though it's not an R38 value, it actually gives you just as much, if not more, insulation right. in the entire coach.
It does.
A couple other cool factors is
the 90 degree cutouts.
Yeah, these cutouts so that you can make a much sharper turn with your short bed truck. So if you only have a 6.5 foot bed, which is actually, I guess, standard nowadays, right?
Most people want that.
Yeah.
They don't want the long beds anymore.
You won't have to slide your slider hitch back nearly as often with something like this.
Exactly. I also want to cover the underneath storage up front. It is a huge compartment allowing you to store everything you want. As you can see, the spare tire is also in here and it's easily accessible. Now, if you needed to put a generator in here, it would be very easy to build a firewall and plumb it to the outside.
While we're over here, I'll also mention that the dry weight of this coach is 10,577. Now, that does not include all the stuff that you might put in your coach, like Correct. Your water and your camping gear.
Food, yeah. clothes.
GVWR is just under 14,000 pounds.
That's good.
Over here, this is where you will run your 6-point auto level system. I like the 6-point auto level system because you push a button, which
after you've pulled away your truck.
Yes, yes.
Then hit the button.
You may have some extra options on your trucks called dents right about the time
we
you
call
forgot
them
to
character.
Yeah, character, that's right. So push auto level, walk away, and you're done.
It's actually enjoyable to watch as it happen.
Yeah.
Okay.
Let's show them the the docking station.
Big opening doors instead of the two doors. Your docking station has everything enclosed. This is part of a true Four Seasons coach. Okay. Everything you need is right here and very accessible, as well as a battery disconnect. So if you ever put it away for the winter and you don't want anything pulling the battery juice, you just hit the disconnect. It also comes with the manual wind up for the cord, because that's a pretty heavy cord. And it will come in handy.
Yeah, especially those 50 amp, they're a lot thicker than the 30 amps.
There, you can see it right there.
Yep.
One of the other things I'd like to touch on, this is a hydraulic system, and it's a one-touch button for all of your slides. So if you don't want to open them all, you have the capability of shutting down one or both of the others and only opening what you want when you want it, okay? As you move from there, tell me about this hot water heater.
This guy is a 10-gallon yep. Gas electric hot water heater. They go with the 10-gallon because you do have the washer dryer hookups in the closet area, which you need at least a 10-gallon to be able to use fill a lot tank. Of water yep. at the same time. But you get the benefit of having a lot hotter shower for longer. And then this has a very quick recovery rate. It's 16.2 gallons of hot water per hour. Before we move on, I wanted to show you that it does have the sprayer as well as the black tank flush, which is kind of nice too.
Always nice to have. 29IK comes with a 50 amp service. Why does it have 50 amp service?
Because if you want to run both your air conditioners at the same time, you need 50 amp.
Correct. Now it also comes with a Suburban heater. And you might be asking yourself, why such a big outside board to hide everything? This allows you to take it off and work on it from the outside rather than going inside and removing panels, drawers, whatever might be in your way to get to it.
Yeah, let's also mention the sewer outlet here. I like that it's just one spot to be able to mess with.
A lot of your bigger coaches have gone to two spots to dump from because they are so big and have so much more tanks involved.
Right.
It is nice to be centrally located in one zone.
And not underneath your slide out, and your dump valves are enclosed where they're going to be protected as well.
We just showed them to you.
All right, what do we want to talk about back here?
Well, we've got this ladder.
Excellent.
What do you want to say about it?
Well, you have a ladder to the roof, which is a one-piece rubber roof, 12-year warranty on it, one of the best in the industry.
Absolutely. The other nice thing is not everybody wants to put their dump hose where all the rest of the stuff goes. So this allows you to slide it in here and put the cap back on it to keep it in there. That's how easy it is. I did it one-handed.
one hand, I mean, the other one you could have tied behind
it
your back?
It was tied to my pocket.
Oh, okay, perfect. Yeah. We also have the backup Furion camera on this guy, and it's wireless. You get a little LCD screen that plugs into the 12-volt outlet in your truck, yep. And you are ready to go, which is super helpful, being able to back up and not bump into things.
That's right. One of the features I really like on these coaches are the frameless windows, okay? From the inside, they open up and they swing out this way. So you can even leave them out if it's raining, because the rain will come down, fall right off, will not go in the coach. If you had the sliding windows, guess what? You got to shut them. On top of that, look at the beautiful cathedral ceiling here we have on this slide. So if any debris, water, whatever gets on there, it'll wash right off. So you're not always having to run up on the roof to make sure there's debris there.
A couple other cool factors I wanted to point out is this has the Easy Flex Dexter suspension system. So that's a much higher grade suspension system, so all your stuff, camping gear, isn't just bouncing around nearly as much as if you just had a normal leaf spring suspension.
One of the other nice features they put with those are the aluminum wheels.
That's right.
Why would you want the aluminum wheels? Well, they disperse heat faster, especially when you're going down those long inclines. You're not going to have braking trouble like on some of the cast iron wheels. The heat builds up and you tend to have a problem.
Ooh, I learned something new today. I was thinking you were going to mention the brass bushings that also come with the Dexter suspension, and or not suspension, but the axles themselves, right?
The axles
instead
themselves.
Of plastic ones.
Exactly.
Here we are on the inside of the 29IK. We are enjoying the Lazy Boy furniture over here.
Lazy Boy couch,
Lazy Boy recliner, and this is not just an exclusive Forest River deal. This is the real Lazy Boy. So did you know there's a cheap Lazy Boy and an expensive Lazy Boy? That's because this guy has the hard piece of wood on the front,
right.
As well as you can lean back in this without having to flip up your feet.
Right.
Lifetime warranty on the mechanisms. And then you can adjust with the turn of a couple wing nuts on the back, how stiff or loose it leans back and forward.
Correct. And I checked a little earlier, this has the pull-out couch. Not a flip down, not a jackknife. No, this is a real pull-out couch.
So two adults could sleep on there?
Two, yes.
That's awesome. And I wouldn't mind sleeping in these recliners as well. The other thing I really like is, I like that if you wanted to, you can even move this guy. Put this guy right in front of the television, right in front of the,
up in the corner.
Fireplace, after you get all set up and you're ready to rock and roll and have a good
Absolutely.
View.
Absolutely. And they can flip the side to side too. This can go over
there. Oh yeah, all
and
the
these
furniture.
Can come over here if you want, whichever setup you like. The other nice thing is we've got this beautiful fireplace. This will heat up and keep about 400 square feet nice and toasty at about 72 degrees. So you don't really have to turn on that heater just because the temperature's starting to drop.
Yeah, so that's an electric versus the furnace is gonna run off of propane.
Absolutely. What about the TV?
Jensen. Jensen is known for being one of the only brands designed for the mobile market. That's super important, obviously, especially in the back of a coach where things are bouncing around and everything.
Right.
They've had problems with other brand TVs where they don't work anymore.
Do you know Jensen is the only manufacturer that crash tests their TVs?
Oh, really?
Yes. They're the only ones.
You put like a dummy in front of it or something? And
they
just
will literally crash it down, throw it down, and test it that way.
Oh, that's interesting. That's great.
The other thing that goes with it is the Jensen surround sound system. You have USB ports. This is AM, FM, CD, DVD.
Bluetooth even.
Bluetooth even. Absolutely. Everything in one. So you're not buying a whole bunch of other stuff to go along with your TV.
You'll notice a lot of these lights are push button. So if you're sitting down, enjoying your whatever, you can turn on and off your lights right in this section. You don't have to walk over to the control panel just to turn
That's
on
right.
this light right here.
Absolutely. The other nice thing that I like is they make sure there are plenty of outlets. Wherever you might need them, you'll find them. Starting in the kitchen, you got 1, 2, 3, 4. You got usually
one over here too.
One
yeah.
behind here, one over here, one on
yep,
the side
there.
They're everywhere you may think you might need to plug something in.
They're uniquely set up to be able to do that because of the hung wall that they use and the real fiberglass in the walls. A lot of guys are doing a laminate wall where that is full of
foam,
yeah, block foam, and you can't put an outlet where there's foam.
No, you can't.
Let's talk about the kitchen.
Absolutely. What have you got over there, mate?
We have a beautiful gas electric refrigerator, not the kind of electric refrigerator that then only runs off the inverter and then the battery system. People sometimes don't like that, and so
that's right.
This is the RV refrigerator instead of a normal household refrigerator.
The true RV enthusiast.
Yes, that's right. Especially if you're going to go up in the mountains and there's not always plug-ins at the national parks and stuff like that.
The other nice thing is the LG solid surface countertop. Very thick, solid stainless steel.
Deep,
50-50, in fact.
Pull down sink faucet. And I like that they don't make this out of plastic either. I like that you actually...
No, they pretend to break and you replace them too often. So it's nice that they have the aluminum piping. The other nice thing on this side is this beautiful table and setup. As you can see, each chair has a hidden compartment underneath each one. Okay, and these tables work like they do at home. Pull it out, pull your leaf out, set it in, push it back in. Gives you a nice table that comes out to about here this far.
Great.
What have you got over there in the kitchen?
We have a real oven, not just the convection microwave that some people, some people want a microwave and a separate oven. This is set up that way. Nice 22-inch size as opposed to the normal 17-inch size that you see. And then you'll notice all the drawers in here. There's a giant hutch over here, lots of drawers, and they all have the nice soft close for that last inch. And you'll notice this is all plywood that's been stapled and screwed together, not just held together by glue.
Those are also the ball bearing duty hinges.
Yeah, and you'll notice they pull out all the way, not the kind that only pull out 3/4 of the way.
And you pull open the cabinets earlier, they also have the European hidden hinges. So you don't have that ugliness on the sides, and they've upgraded their hardware for the handles too this year.
Kind of a brushed
nickel.
Very nice.
Yeah. Absolutely. All right.
Go for it.
No, you go.
All right. I was going to mention the Whisper Quiet air conditioner.
I felt you would.
You thought I was, and I am. The cool thing about that is it has the return ducts on the side of the coach instead of the giant AC in the middle that makes a ton of noise. And that is not only true in here, but also in the bedroom.
In the bedroom, and we'll get to that in a minute.
Yep. And LED lights?
Oh, throughout the whole coach. And why do you want LED lights?
They run a lot cooler, so in the summertime, you're not fighting your air conditioner.
Right.
And?
Longer lasting.
Longer lasting.
Absolutely.
Not only lifetime-wise, but also during your camp trip, so you're not running down your battery.
Yep.
As we're heading up, I wanted to show you this is the dual zone Dometic thermostat, so you can control everything from here, from both your heat to your air conditioning, as well as the high-powered Creative Breeze Fantastic Fan that has the rain sensor on it, so it will automatically shut if it starts raining. One more thing, it does have the central vac system built into it right here, and then this is your control panel, and one of the cool things they just recently added this year is it's already pre-wired for the solar panel. So if you wanted to add solar, it cuts down on the labor by having those wires already fished through the entire system.
Why don't you head on up this way and we'll talk to you about the bathroom. As you can see, the bathroom even comes with an LG solid surface countertop. Very rare in a lot of your fifth wheels today. Moen faucet still. And look at this shower. Absolutely all the room in the world. It's really a two-person shower if you want it to be. But for me, I prefer the seat so when I shave my legs, I don't have any problems. It also has the, what do you call the triple door here?
Oh yeah, triple slide door or whatever. Oh, you have to unlock it, but yeah.
Yeah, we'll unlock it first. I'll show you how easy it works.
So question for you, Gary, is that leg shaving for your Olympic swimming that you're doing? Or?
Yes, it is.
I knew it.
Thank you for mentioning it.
You'll notice this guy is also porcelain instead of plastic.
And they also have quite a bit of cabinetry space, hidden hinges once again, toilet paper, towels, whatever you need, and a real medicine chest with the opening doors.
Excellent. And another Creative Breeze fan up above you.
Absolutely.
as we're moving in here to the bathroom or the bedroom area, you'll notice that we have a king size bed with walk around space on both sides. You don't find that. Usually it's very cramped at this point, and you even have a little spot for hanging coats. And you'll notice I'm not bumping my head quite yet either.
No.
That's because this is a barreled roof, which is super nice to give you that extra large feeling, not to mention the cathedral slide out, so that when you wake up in the middle of the night, you're not like nailing your head.
It gives you that little bit more clearance.
Yeah.
Yeah. And the other thing we wanted to show, we showed you downstairs and we said it was in the bedroom, is the Whisper Quiet Voila. Air conditioners here too.
You know, I also like that these things open and close and that you can point them in the right direction as well for your air conditioner, which is sitting right here. You just can't see it because it's the Whisper Quiet.
That's right. And the other thing, even upstairs, you have the easy close drawers. Start it and it'll pull itself right in. Okay. Last but not least, we would like to show you the storage under the bed.
There you go. And it has the nice struts, so you're not having to hold this with your hand to be able to throw some blankets or pillows or whatnot. And this is a Serta mattress instead of a Sorta mattress. Here in the closet, we have a laundry hamper there, but you'll notice that they finish off everything in here as well. So not only do you have the nice mirrors, but you have three different hanging bars to hang your stuff. You also have the washer dryer hookup. You have the spots to put shoes or whatever else you might need, as well as little drawers that pull out inside the closet, which, man, it's like these guys thought through it methodically.
Absolutely. And there it is, all wrapped up in a nutshell for you. It's a 29IK Silverback Cedar Creek.
Gary, I think for your first video, you deserve an Oscar for this, man.
I'll tell you, I'm shooting for that Oscar award. But thank you for viewing the Cedar Creek Silverback 29IK edition.
If you have any questions, you can reach us at thegreatoutdoorsrv.com is our website, or our email is gary@thegreatoutdoorsrv.com.
Yep.
You can reach us on our phone number is...
It's 970-313-4337.
All right. Thanks, guys.
Thank you. Have a good one.